This is a wetland restoration. We are completing a sediment scrape on this wetland basin. This site was continuously farmed for about 100 years, and that topsoil has washed from higher elevations on the landscape into lower spots down here. We've done a soils investigation and identified that there is a layer of sediment there that has essentially filled this wetland. And so what we've done is we've brought a contractor in, he's taken an excavator and peeled back layers of that sediment, removed it from this wetland, and then what he's gonna basically do is come in and kind of smooth up the sides a little bit. These wetlands will filter groundwater, they provide habitat for different types of wildlife. They can also serve as a source for aquifer recharge. This work is being done under the Wetland Reserve Program. This easement was enrolled right around 2012 into a permanent conservation easement with USDA NRCS. And through that program, we restore the wetlands and whatever is there with the upland areas back to pre-settlement conditions prior to European settlement. So some of that work would involve removing sediment from wetlands, breaking tiles that have drained wetlands, and reseeding native grasses or whatever native vegetation was on the landscape. We're basically just trying to put it back the way that it was and restore it back to the condition it was before it was altered. It probably won't pond water for very much throughout the year. It'll be more of a temporary wetland that holds water in the spring after snowmelt. Rain falls in the spring and dries out, more than likely will dry out during most summers. What these shallow temporary wetlands will do is just provide diversity on the landscape to provide habitat for migratory wildlife and wetland-dependent wildlife species. This project is about roughly about the size of most of the sediment scrapes that we do. This one is a little bit drier than most of the sites that we work on, so things are going pretty good here. The landowner is the Cook Waterfowl Foundation. Cook Waterfowl contacted NRCS because their goals of restoring and protecting waterfowl habitat aligns with the same goals that NRCS has through the WRP program. Cook has owned this land since sometime in the 1990s. The easement went in 2012, and that's when we kind of started our partnership. Yep.
I see that's all broom, and then the one on the other side.
There's a bunch of bluegrass and stuff along the other side too. So what we've got off in the distance is a prescribed burn. We're hoping to accomplish a couple different things with that prescribed burn. One of the things that we'd hope to accomplish is to set back some of the brush that's starting to invade the prairie. And secondly, what we'd like to do is we'd like to burn off some of the thatch layer off the surface, and that will allow us to come back in next spring into certain areas that have native grasses but lack flowers and lack diversity. And we're hoping to come in next spring and come back in and add some diversity through interseeding and drilling in flowers and forb species. The engineering was done by Steve Girard. He, you know, basically started by identifying spots on the landscape that were altered in some capacity, and then, you know, figuring out how we can restore those back to the way or as close as we can get to what they originally would have been.
Basically, we're kind of finishing up here. There originally was a CRP contract out here where they restored a lot of these wetlands, and now we're coming back in and we're trying to finish up small basins that have been missed. And also we have some tile removal on the east side that we're going to do because they're still draining the wetland areas over there. What we do when we come out to a site, we survey the area, and then specifically on this one, we surveyed the areas that we were going to excavate. We did soil borings to see how deep the sediment was in the wetland areas, the basins, the small ones, and then we figured out how much material would be removed at a certain depth. The amount that'll get excavated here is probably 6 inches to 12 inches. And basically you can see the black ground that's behind me, and the light soil that he's removing is actually sediment from the top of the hill. The one thing we keep in mind when we're doing our engineering projects is we don't over excavate We don't get into enhancement and creation. We try to put back what's originally there. On the outside edge, we always try to slope that back to a 6-to-1 or flatter. And what that does is it makes it usable to birds, so young birds can go in and out of the pond easily, and they can move on to the bigger ponds that are here, which are important for later in the season. With this landowner, we took into account, because they're very active, they want to manage. They're very active in the management of their properties. And what we do is we try to get them involved because we want to get their input and try to meet their goals as well as ours and see if we can make those come together. They wanted to enhance the wetland complex out here. They had the deep wetlands, they have the larger wetlands. Now they want to try to add to it with the type ones and twos, which are important for spring habitat, for mating and courtship areas. And also, these pools heat up a lot quicker, so the invertebrates inevitably are more active here, and the birds will start, as soon as they're hatched, they'll hit these areas, and the young birds will get protein, which is important to their diet.
A little bit of the history of the property is that it was originally purchased by Cook Waterfowl Foundation in 1999. And we did initial wetland restorations, several of them at our own expense and with the Partners for Fish and Wildlife program. But as the property matured, we learned more and more about it, and we learned that we had missed quite a few of the wetland restorations the first time around. This work is important because there's very few of these seasonal wetlands left. They're among the most at-risk wetlands on the landscape, the prairie pothole landscape, because they're the most easily filled by wind and water erosion. Through the 30s, 40s, 50s, and 60s, the plowing farming was based on deep plowing technology. And these were very light soils here, so there was a lot of wind and water erosion, which filled these wetlands up and made them so they didn't function as wetlands any longer. The NRCS has outstanding design capabilities and staffing now to bring the properties up to their full potential for waterfowl, because the wetlands are so important, not only for waterfowl, but for groundwater recharge and other wildlife, game and non-game species. And so you can restore them to their original waterfowl productivity by removing the sediments. And now they'll be restored for invertebrate production and plant species to benefit waterfowl. And that's a lot of what the work is that's going on here today. Cook Waterfowl Foundation has been in business restoring wetland habitat since 1979. We've restored probably somewhere north of 700 wetlands since we started, and about 8,000 acres of nesting cover. As we get funds in from WRP from one, we use it to buy another property and do the same thing. Although we're just on a small scale compared to the landscape needs, it's the type of work that's really necessary, is getting some permanent set aside. Compared to how many million acres there are in the state, there's only about 2.5% set aside for conservation. Here in North Dakota, it drops to perhaps 1%. So we have to make the most out of what is left here. The way the partnership has worked over the years is, as we buy a piece of property, the Fish and Wildlife Service Partners Program would come in and do the broad brush strokes with the larger wetland restorations, and then NRCS would come in as we put them into WRP and do the fine tuning to get them up to their maximum waterfowl productivity. Once the sediment is removed, the wetlands require very little additional work because the plant communities are still intact. These type of prairie wetlands can be farmed for years, and when water is added back onto them or sediment removed, the natural plant community and species composition comes back. People are constantly amazed at how long lived some of these plant seeds, such as smartweed and bulrush, can survive. This property will be fully restored within 2 years now after this collaboration with NRCS, which we would not have been able to do otherwise. As you see, there's quite a prairie grass component behind me that's already existing, that we planted. But this upland component will also be enhanced. This is a three species mix, and we're gonna add in four or five other prairie terrestrial species to this to make it more, even more productive than it is. The importance of restoring wetlands like this is it restores the natural wetland complex to the landscape. You can come in and restore your permanent wetlands and semi-permanent class 4 and 5, but it's the seasonals that are the heart of waterfowl production on the prairie. And they're the most fragile wetlands, that is, they fill the soonest and they're the most vulnerable to man-made changes to the landscape. And so by putting the seasonal wetlands, the smaller wetlands that have been filled, you restore the primary building block for waterfowl production, in that it is these seasonal wetlands which are the most productive of invertebrates. They're the first to warm up in the spring, and it's what hens need for nutrition, for egg laying and waterfowl production. The partnership with NRCS has been outstanding. They've gotten better and better, and their staffing has gotten better and better, and their people have been great to work with over these past several years. We're really glad to be partners with them on these WRP enhancements.